During the 1990s, the Getty Conservation Institute, working with an international team of engineers and conservators, carried out a multi-year research and testing program called the Getty Seismic Adobe Project. The project sought to develop seismic retrofit techniques for existing adobe buildings that would have minimal and reversible impact on historic structures. Cost and difficulty of installation were important considerations. Shake table tests were first performed at Stanford University on small-scale models. These studies led to the selection of two retrofit methods that were then tested on larger, half-size models at the Institute of Earthquake Engineering and Engineering Seismology in Skopje, in the Republic of Macedonia. This video documents the shake table tests of the large-scale unretrofitted control model, followed by the retrofitted model. Both models were subjected to 8 simulated earthquake motions of increasing intensity. The shake table moved in one direction, subjecting the east and west gable end walls to out-of-plane forces. The unretrofitted control, Model 10, was the first to be tested. Crack damage began during Test 3. Dynamic motions of the upper sections of the walls were slightly discernible. They became more apparent during Tests 4 and 5, when the roof system rocked back and forth and cracking grew more significant. Test 6 had significant out-of-plane motions of the gable end walls. Cracks developed more fully. In Test 7, the wall probably would have overturned had it not been restrained by the roof framing system. In this test, the first diagonal in-plane cracks developed in the north and south walls. During the final test of the series, Test 8, the east gable end wall collapsed from the center rather than overturning due to restraint by the roof system. A second test model, Model 11, was retrofitted using two different techniques, each applied to two adjacent walls. The north and east walls were strengthened using 2 horizontal and 4 vertical nylon straps. The south and west walls were retrofitted with 2 horizontal nylon straps and 4 vertical steel rods set in center cores with an epoxy grout. The roof frame was secured to the walls with vertical bolts set in epoxy grout. A partial roof diaphragm and ceiling joists worked to hold the tops of the walls together. This retrofitted model was subjected to the same series of shake table motions as the control model. Crack damage did not develop until Test 4, as opposed to Test 3 for the control model. Cracks did not propagate until Test 5. The vertical straps did not prevent crack damage in the west wall, but they did affect the dynamic performance after cracks developed. During Test 6, the east wall sustained significant displacements, yet the building did not suffer any measurable offsets at the cracks. During the strong ground motions of Tests 6 through 8, the walls with vertical straps sustained higher levels of damage than the walls with the vertical center cores. While vertical cracks developed at roughly the same time in all the walls, horizontal cracks occurred later in the walls with center core rods. Test 7 demonstrated significant difference in the behavior of the two sets of walls. The north and east walls with the vertical straps suffered large displacements, causing large loads to develop in the vertical and horizontal straps. Spalling continued, with large cracks opening and permanent offsets at several cracks. At the same time, the south and west walls with center core rods sustained relatively minor damage. Cracks developed in the south and west walls, but these were relatively minor and there were no offsets. During the final test, large dynamic displacements occurred, but the wall, although significantly damaged, never appeared close to collapse. The performance of the retrofitted model demonstrated the effectiveness of both retrofit methods in minimizing the likelihood of catastrophic collapse during an earthquake.